Now, this is why I enjoy overlanding so much. All the weird things you see on the road and all the interesting wild camping spots where you can camp. And I get a chance to play in the sand like a kid with my 4x4 toy and test the stuff to its limits. Man, this is the life with all the fantastic places you visit and the fantastic people you meet, experiences on the road. Come, join us on our Tankwa, Richtersveld, and West Coast trip. This is an epic one.
Welcome to the Broken Spoon Restaurant.
It's hard to believe that that river there, with the recent flash flood less than a month ago, was all the way up there by those bathrooms and was running into the bathrooms. What is that? That is a 15 meter raise. It is just crazy. Quite a drop down here. Shoo. Never expected the road to be this treacherous.
And swim in Balu. Ooh.
Driving in the clouds now. Actually, a beautiful valley this.
Yeah.
Stopped on the right hand side as you're coming up. I'm not sure if this is the point you're talking about.
Dunno, you tell me where there's a good spot.
The clouds on me on your right.
Okay, we're on top of the Katbakkies Pass on our way to the Tankwa Padstal, and we're on top of the world.
In the Kultistan,
Very seldom you see so much water down there. We had so much rain the last month.
Shit, oh,
it's a very thirsty place, sister.
Okay. You're gonna stand there and give me one or what?
Thank you. I was contemplating drinking, but.
Tuma.
Look like a flying UFO landed here. That's our idea. Look at that. Take this, the venster. There's a UFO that made a crash landing. And here's a car that made a crash landing. So it's World Cup time, and look at that. Go Boca. Let's hope they do it. They're playing tomorrow night in the semi-finals against England. A farm stall in the middle of nowhere.
Tankwa
park. This looks like a nice bike trip too, Rinda. We must try that sometime.
Yes.
Ons keier een hond uit de bos is op bij die werkswinkel pub. Bij die Tankwa padstal. Dus een must visit is in die area kom, right?
That night we slept over at Roy Ducky's campsite. Of course they've got a bar where you can watch the semi-final of the All Blacks versus Argentina. And here I'm spending some quality time with my dog. In a bar just before the match and morning after having a coffee, getting ready for the road. On the road you meet some very interesting people. This is a common sight in South Africa and they are always pleasant and friendly. Another quick pit stop at the farm stall for Derek to catch up on his admin and to have a lovely breakfast. Surprisingly nice with some bacon, egg and cheese. Taking the road to a pub called Dardur. And here we arrive. Look at the wind there on the left of the flag. The wind was pumping. So we are supposed to watch the game here tonight. But the wind is so hectic that we couldn't look at, even think of putting it up a tent. So now we're waiting and discussing what we're going to do next. Eventually we came to the conclusion that we'll have to find another place to camp for the night, somewhere out of the wind, because there's no way we can do it there. Right, here we are on the road, on our way to Ganega Lodge.
Dis my kontry, dis in wereld die, nie net vir my. Die vlakte is oop, hier en daar is lood, daar voel ek vry, want dis my eie kontry. O nee, my saam, ek wil huis toe gaan.
We were supposed to sleep at a place called Dardur, which is basically a pub in the middle of the Karoo, but the wind was howling there and there was no ways that Derek could set up a tent there. So we drove further, a very interesting road, and came here at Ganega Lodge. Beautiful setup here. Let me show you the inside of the room. With a nice toilet and shower facilities here too. So we still slept in the van with the dogs, but Derek and Natalie slept in the room similar to this. Now the guys have got amenities here of note. Look at the nice view. Beautiful inside with a big screen TV. Watched the rugby there last night. Nice shaded stoop area. When I said we were on a trip and we're going to rough it a bit, this is not actually what I had in mind, guys.
Very rough breakfast.
It was rough.
Sitting in that hotel and eating breakfast full on.
A
lodge. A lodge, okay. A lodge.
Ganega
Lodge.
In the Tankwa Karoo.
Sorry, I have to repeat everything the wife says, otherwise I'm in trouble. Okay, there's a little town here in the middle of nowhere called Middelpos. And Derek is upset because the hotel is closed. He wanted to have a beer, but it's one of those towns that on a Sunday everything is closed.
Was 10 bokkies wyd, Bator te koer en was lange boer Pony me saam Ek wil huis toe gaan Daar waar ek s'nas Nog rustig kan slaap Door hanne kraai My wakker maak Die morgen stond Leg uit in my mond As ek terug verlang Na my geboorteland O neem my saam Ek wil ons toe gaan Na my kontry
Try that uniformly that you can have it. Hello.
The only reason why I did is to save the...
Yeah, you're going home. Not with us. Sorry. Bye-bye. So Derek's taking the pot so we can have a hot shower. Bucket showering 101.
You got your water warm? To the donkey. Watch your bucket here. That water is lukewarm, well, warm enough now that I don't need cold water.
Nah, I'm too devilish. I'm not going to take a small squeeze. I'm going to show you.
So this is how you do it.
Derek and Natalie is going back to Cape Town. They're pushing on to Pella. Shame, guys. Feel sorry for you.
Feel sorry yeah. for us as well. Yeah, but at least I can drink some lekker hot coffee.
On the other hand, we got rid of them, Renda. We got rid of them.
Neo,
no. No, it was great,
try.
Guys.
I don't think normality was
lovely having you.
We're going to miss
you. We are here at Klein Pella Guest House, which has got camp facilities as well. And we've got our own private campsite with hot water, electricity, nice shade trees, beautiful view of the mountains. And we've got our own ablution facility as well. Part of the trip we're doing with Aletta and Gerard, they are my brother and sister-in-law and Renda's sister.
Like a brain.
So Aletta has been camping for quite a bit longer than us. She is tanned as hell. And this is their little site. Same story with their own private ablution. That night I made a deboned lamb rib stuffed with bacon, mushrooms, feta cheese and some pesto basil. It came out really special. Alright, our first pit stop, or so I say piss stop. Going well, except that the roads are very corrugated.
I, oh,
Now look at this creative idea. A vegetable tunnel that's made out of plastic bottles. Dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true.
It's very, very hot. They're just gonna have to cool off now. This is the Orange River.
Look at this, it's a beautiful river here. And we are not alone here, there are other campers here as well. Looks like they came with down with canoes by the looks of it. Yeah, but this water was refreshing. It is quite hot. It must be close to 40 degrees. Now we're camping the way I like it. Out here by a nice river, on the banks of the river, with a bonfire going on the side. There's the public toilet. There's the public shower. There's the old wife.
Hey! And the old sister-in-law.
And the sister-in-law, yes.
The grey one.
And we've actually got neighbors here, very nice guys that are actually paddling down the river and sleeping along the river every night. Just the way I like it. Someday you wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. And was very loose. It took two attempts to get out here.
Oh,
it was still damn hot, so we filled the Stanley water bottle with ice just to try and cool down.
Bloody lifesaver.
Okay. This is the sheep here, this is houses.
Out here in the middle of nowhere.
Anton and Baloo cooling off.
Whatever. Came to visit, yeah, right here by the camp. And this one is unaware of anything. Even if the little baby. Hey, look at that. Isn't that cute? Look there, two little babies and a mom. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky. Also on the faces of people passing by, I see friends shaking and singing, how do you do? They're really safe. I love you. I hear babies cry and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more. What a wonderful world, world. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind.
lemon drops high above the chimney top. That's where you find me, oh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high. And the dream that you dare to, why, oh, why can't I ooh.
So here we were sitting happily talking nonsense on a beautiful day, and suddenly a gust of wind came through here that was just unbelievable. It took that gazebo right over that caravan and made a nice dent in Gerard's brand new Fortuner. So we'll have to have that sorted out. And the gazebo obviously is in bits and pieces. We were supposed to move on to the next camp, but since the Springboks were playing in the World Cup rugby final, we weren't going to miss that. So we left the day early, and listen to this. We drove to the little town of Springbok to go and watch the Springboks play in the final of the World Cup. Isn't that awesome? We ended up watching the World Cup final in a nursery that has been converted to a restaurant for the night, and it was a really nice evening. The last leg of the trip was all along the west coast from the Richtersveld, and this section Renda and I did on our own. We found a nice secluded beach where we decided to stay for a day or three. The perfect little wild camping spot, because it's nice and secluded, private, and there's no wind. Taking an afternoon nap after a long day's driving.
I don't know what you're gonna eat, this is all mine.
Uh-huh. Suit yourself.
So when the weather is grotty, we make it into a positive event. I've got this little Romasco oven that uses very little energy. So we're running this off the inverter, and we are making ourselves a very nice dinner here. Look at this. Potatoes. That has got bacon around it, chicken, fried chicken with some mini onions. Man, oh man, that looks good. Now this is the way to spend a cold day. In bed with the wife and the dogs, watching a movie on a laptop with a view of the sea in front. Yes, Baloo.
What are you going to do now? Your morning duties.
I'm going to dig a hole. Don't ask why.
Okay, don't worry. Enjoy.
Business.
Enjoy.
There's a company called Namakwa Sand. They're mining for sand here. This whole area actually belongs to them, if I'm not mistaken.
the troll again, so I invited the French chef to cook for me tonight.
Ah, merci. Welcome to the Broken Spoon restaurant. This is our little petite restaurant. Petite means very small for you idiots that are illiterate. Today we're making my famous green bean stew with lamb that I'm going to pre-fry in the butter. Remember, it must be butter, otherwise it is no good. And then we are going to add the green beans and then the inner farman. That is just an African delicacy. No sponsors ad. Yeah, I just love that stuff. Yeah. Then we're going to make this, and later we're going to put it all into that pot there, and then we're going to cook it for very, very, very long. And then you will see that, wow, magnifique, man, magnifique. Just wait and see. Just wait and see. Now get out of my face. I need to work.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Good morning. So after that lovely stew last night, we're going to take the leftovers and warm it up, put it into one of these containers, and then it stays warm in here, and then we can eat it on the road. We're leaving soon, don't know where yet. We'll see where it looks nice. This is our last stopover on our way home. This is a campsite called Markeskraal. It's about 20 kilometers north of Citrusdal. Really a well-kept, beautiful site. It's on a working farm, and they are fruit farmers. So let me tell you about my driver assist gadget. Really wonderful thing. Warns you when you are approaching a traffic light. Warns you when you haven't got your safety belt on. Tells you when you're driving too far to the left, too far to the right. It's just amazing. And if you tells you when the light is gone green and you should be going now, tells you when it's orange, stop now, tells you when you're veering off the road. You might be wondering, what is this gadget? It's called the wife.
Aye. Yo. Salut, Beto. Bye.
Okay, and the same token, I must say, we are heading home now. I couldn't have chosen better partners than the two dogs. And the wife. No, it's been wonderful. Thanks, Brenda. You're just amazing.
It was great, thanks.